He was beautiful. I was just a beautiful little boy. He had a full head of brown hair. Absolutely precious. We adored him. The kids were so happy to have him. So excited. Basil spent his first 17 days in the NICU at University of Washington, and he spent his last week at the cardiac ICU at Children's Hospital. So in between there, he was home. He was doing just great, and then all of a sudden, his heart stopped. It was awful. It was a nightmare. We didn't get to hold him as long as we wanted to. It was torture to have to leave our baby laying on the table and walk away.
Grief can rip families apart. It's a very scary and confusing and very difficult thing for someone to lose somebody that dear and close to them.
Patsy was an artist all her life. We were in love and it was just beautiful. Just beautiful. We had a wonderful time for quite a few years. We were not in a position to accept the fact that she was going to die. I was thinking of suicide sometimes. I was not a happy time. I just didn't want to live this way in total misery. I couldn't see any way out of it. It was just like, it's a hopeless situation, endless despair. I was trapped in this cycle of grief with no way out. And the program enabled me to find a way out. And I found the way out. And it's beautiful.
People come into the program broken in a sense, and they're looking for help and asking for help. They leave feeling like they have been given that help, that they have tools. They are able to parent again. They are able to still have the memories and the love of the person that they've lost, but they can look forward to a new day.
I am truly grateful to attend this grief recovery group. It's like when you're standing out in the rain and all of a sudden the sun clears. You know, the clouds clear and it's sunny. It was like that for me.